Yes, my people, good day. It is happening. We are underway, starting the rebuild of the BMW N20 engine. Here, I am removing the fuel injector. Check it out. That's a fuel injector.
That's what it look like there. More than likely, them have a specialty tool for that, man. I spray penetrating fluid in there, so. Help it to come out a little easier. You number them. 1, 2, 3 stroke. 1, 2, 3, 4 stroke. I mark them in different places, so in case something happened, I want to put them back in the same spot. Fuel injectors. Break them loose first. This is my first time pulling one of these apart, so. We have to proceed with caution. This is plastic. Let's give it a little tap. Bam. These come out. And there's a gasket under here. Get my sandwich bags. Keep everything together. So now I know that when I get this bag, it has to do with the injectors and these. You understand? Speed of reassembly is important. Number this tool. So this is 1 and this is 2. So then we know 1 and 2 is here and cylinder number 3 in that one. Yep. I don't know if it makes a difference or not. Not trying to figure it out. So we just mark it. Put this away. There's a gasket for it. Buy new ones. So if you're getting oil on the spark plugs, it would be this leaking. That's what it looks like now. And then now this is the eccentric cam for the variable valve lift. That's a solenoid right there, electronic. There's a plug for it. So it gives variable valve lift. That's the eccentric shaft. So it's set up all kind of funky. Still waiting on the tool to relieve these springs. Gonna get that doing, then get these cams up, because what happened is down there are the bolts for the head. That's a head bolt. That's a head bolt. And there's a head bolt under there. You understand? So this shaft has to come out the way. So you have to take that apart. Take this off.
Right now, I am starting to remove the bolts for the timing chain guide, but it was sitting on the table keeping pressure on the guide itself. So I'm just propping the front of the engine up a little bit to give it a little room. So now you see it's movable. I like it like that. So there are some plugs in the front of the engine. I remove them, and then through the hole for the plug, you can reach the bolts for the timing chain guide. So that's what I'm removing now. It is what, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, 3 bolts, 2 of them long, and then one of them is a little bit short. And then we have the 2 small ones at the top that I'm removing now. And then after I remove them bolts, we can now proceed to start removing the cam gear, which already broke the bolts loose. And then we can take the cam gear off. But I'm going to talk to you more about the cam gear in the video. So stick around.
Yep. That's been on. Anyway, I don't want to get anything mixed up. I don't know if it's the same or not. So I mark everything. Yo, we deep out. We deep in there now. We are deep in there. Mark everything. Not sure if I'm reusing those, but still, everything should lift out. My first rodeo. Blue. Look at that. Blue. Look at that. Yo, that crazy. That is crazy. Yeah.
There. Let me talk to you a few minutes about the importance of spending the money and buying the specialty tools
if you're going to attempt to do any kind of timing chain related repairs or adjustment on these modern engines. What happened is these manufacturers now, so this is the crankshaft pulley. Notice there are no keyways made into these anymore. They're all smooth. They just press onto the crankshaft themselves. So this by itself on the crankshaft would just be freewheeling. There's no designated spot. Like back in the day, there used to be a dowel and a keyway that locates it. You can put it on cylinder number one, top dead center on the compression stroke, and then you can match everything up. It changed. Them changed that now. So there's no reliefs here for nothing. This is the cam gear, the intake cam gear. That is smooth, and that one is smooth as well. Don't forget my book. You know, my book is on Amazon. Make sure so you pick one up, support the thing. Yes, so check it out now. This is the tool I had to purchase because I am doing the rebuild on this BMW M20 engine, Nancy 20, right? They call it a 528. I am not going to get into it much, but it is not a 2.8 liter. It is a 2.0 liter. So you get the bait and switch, but that is for another video. You understand? 528i, and this is a 2.0. It should be a 520 so that everybody know up front. Say it's not a 2.8. It's not a six cylinder. It's actually a four cylinder in this big 5 series car. So you have something closer to a Honda Civic than you do a BMW. I said I wasn't going to get into it. Anyway, so this is the cam gear right here. Notice that it is smooth. There are no keyways on the exhaust cam, and on the intake cam, there are no keyways here. It's smooth. The crankshaft is the same. We already have the crankshaft out. It is smooth. So when you put in these gears on, there's no way to line them up unless you have the tool. So take a look at this right here now. On the camshaft, on the back, there's a flat right here. And there is a flat right here. And there is also a flat on this side. And a flat on that side. You see them? See that flat right there? See that right there? So these flats, when the camshafts are in the correct location, coincide with these slots on the tool. So now when you install the tool and then the tool sits flat on the head, these slots slide over the camshaft to line them up in the correct location. And then this tool, you see these little two dowels here, you notice them? Go on the front, let me show you where these go. This would go like so. This is my first time doing it, by the way. So let me tell you, we learning together, right? So you see these little dowels here? Remember, this is the exhaust. You see that little hole? Lines up with that little dowel, right? So when it lines up with it, let me take it off and show it to you. So when it line up with the little dowel like so, see that? When it line up with that, now these spots now for the cam sensors now get located as well, because this is lined up here. And then it is centered when it is bolted to the camshaft. So that is how you get your timing and all of that stuff line up. You have to have the tool. You can't guess it. You can't guess it, because if you're off a tooth, this thing don't run properly. So you have to spend the money. So again, I am thankful for a lower cost alternative to be able to get these special tools, because the European version of these, you can't afford to buy them, for use them one time, possibly two times. You understand what I'm saying? So, that's the situation. Just wanted to share that to you. And then also share the elaborate timing chain guide setup. Metal is a whole metal against plastic. You know what I mean? How long that gonna last? But hey, the engineers know best. So that's what I'm doing. That's what I'm working on. So waiting on a tool to undo these springs today. Should be here today. And then when I can do that, then now I'll be able to remove this out the way and be able to take the head off. Then we can look at the pistons, and then we can give out the block and the head to the machine shop this week so that them can start cleaning out the oil galleries. You had a spun bearing, so therefore you have metal particles passing through the oil galleries going to places where metal shouldn't be. So curious to see what's going on under these cam caps. Make sure there's not much damage, taking as much precaution as possible to ensure a problem-free or minimize the problems going forward, going down the road, because everybody know my situation. I can't afford to put the wife into this, and then now, we're just not running right. What did you do? You understand what I'm saying? So, there we go. Yeah, man. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Bless you.